Hello, and welcome to Verbling. My name is Teacher Oakley, and in today's class, we're going to be looking at more basic food vocabulary. Yesterday, at this time slot, we looked at meat and fish. Today, we're going, instead of the carnivore route, meat eater, we're going the vegetarian route. Today, we're going to be looking at fruits and vegetables and learning the vocabulary related to fruits and vegetables. Okay, should be fun. We'll be doing some mix and match exercises, hopefully. Maybe some fill-in-the-blank exercises to learn collocations and verbs and adjectives that we use to talk about fruits and vegetables. As well, we'll discuss a little bit if you have these types of fruits and vegetables in your culture, if people eat these things or grow them in your country. Okay, let me start by welcoming some students to the class. Hello, Mike. How are you?
Hello, Oakley.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you today?
I am fine. Nice to see you. How are you?
I'm doing okay. Thank you. Thank you very much. I would also like to welcome Jorge. Hello.
Hello. I'm doing great.
Great. Terrific. I'm okay. All things considered. Pretty good. Okay. Plenty of room in the class for those viewers outside in Verbling who want to join us. Come on in. You can join anytime. Not a big deal. But let's get started because we have a ton of material here. Because why? Because there's a ton of fruits and vegetables in the world, people. That's why. Okay. Quick welcome to Seth. Hello, Seth.
Yes. Hi, teacher.
Hi, Seth. Welcome to the class.
Thank you.
Where are you from?
I'm from Mexico.
Oh, okay. Terrific. Thanks for joining us. And I would also like to welcome Armando to the class. Hello, Armando.
Hello. How are you?
Hi. I'm good. Thanks. Okay. I'm going to do a screen share now, and we're going to start with a little food identification 101. A little mix and match with pictures. Let's give it a try. Okay, here we go. Okay, Mike, let's start with an easy one. We're going to match the words with the pictures. Now I'm going to have to scroll down because there's a lot of pictures here. But, Mike, first one, where is the apple? Number 12. Very good.
Yeah.
Pardon me. Of course, there are many, many, I have no idea how many, but many, many varieties or types of apples. Mike, do you like apples?
Yeah, I like apples.
All right.
Apples, yeah.
Apples. Do they grow them in your country?
Sorry?
Do they grow apples in your country?
Yeah.
Yeah, apples?
Many apples.
Everywhere. Grow apples everywhere, really.
Yeah.
I don't know any country that doesn't have apples. All right. In English, here's a little idiom for you. If you do something that's surprising or impressive, you might say, how about them apples? Or how do you like them apples? And yes, how do you like them apples? It doesn't sound right. I know. It's colloquial. It's an English expression. Anyway. Okay. Well, how do you like them apples? All right. Let me welcome a couple new students to the class. Aletha. Hello, hello.
Hello. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you, and welcome. And Alejandro has joined us. Hello, Alejandro.
Hello, nice to see you.
Good to see you as well. Okay, let's continue with our basic food identification. 101. Jorge, can you find me a pair? I'll scroll down slowly.
Number 7?
Number 7, yes, very good. A pear has a pear shape. okay, we often use a pear as an adjective to describe the shape because of its unique tapered end. When one end of something comes narrows almost to a point, we can say that it's tapered. All right. Do you like pears?
Yeah. I do.
Yeah, okay. Great. Yeah. All right. We can zip through this. Okay, next one's easy, Seth. You got an easy one.
Okay. Bananas is the number 3.
Yeah, of course. Now, okay, when I'm American, and when I lived in the United States, basically we had one kind of bananas. Okay. That's all everybody ate. But now I live in the Philippines, I realize that there are very many varieties of bananas. Here in the Philippines, I don't know, there's at least 12 different kinds of bananas. Not to mention related fruits, plantains. Red bananas. I like red bananas. Seth,
yes.
do you eat bananas?
Yes. Every week, yes.
Every week? Me too.
Yeah.
My family buys bananas every week. Very healthy, high in potassium. Very good for you.
Yes.
Indeed. Okay, moving on. Armando, how about the next one?
Lemon, number 5.
What color are lemons, Armando?
Yellow.
Yes, they are. And what are the green ones called that are a little bit smaller but same shape? similar to a lemon, but much smaller, half the size maybe, but green.
Lima.
Okay, I knew you were going to say that. In English, we call it a lime. We use a long I for a lime. Okay. All right. Well, limes and lemons, two different things. Okay. Do you know what kind of fruit, Armando, we call things like lemons and limes, oranges, grapefruit, tangerines? Do you know what kind of fruit that those are called?
I don't understand. Repeat the question.
I'm not saying it well, but okay. Fruits that grow on trees that have a high degree of ascorbic acid, vitamin, they have a lot of vitamin C, and they're very sour, not always, but okay, never mind, I'm not explaining it well. Orange, lemons, limes, these are called citrus fruit.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, they have an outside skin, usually very high.
They are sour.
They are very often sour, yeah. Okay, maybe not so much an orange. Elisa, can you find an orange?
Orange is number 4.
Yeah, obviously number 4. There are different varieties and types of oranges as well. Elisa, do they grow oranges in your country?
Yes, I have a lot of, but I don't eat orange. I drink juice.
Okay, orange juice.
Yes.
Sure. Orange juice, of course, extremely popular. All right. Okay, the next one. The next one's kind of hard because I don't think the picture's very good, but skipping to the next line, Alejandro.
Yep.
See it?
In the first line.
Peach. Yeah, here we go. Peach is what we're looking for. And yeah. Scroll down.
Number 7, maybe?
Or 7 is a pair. Pair. Oh. In English, it's an A sound, like air, pair. No, and I have to tell you, the picture's it's terrible. Honestly, this is a hard one.
No, I don't know the what
okay.
Peach is.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm going to have to help you out because it's a terrible picture. I think 9, through process of elimination, I figured it out preparing for the class, but I couldn't tell from this terrible picture. I think 9 is supposed to be a peach, but terrible. It's a terrible picture because the inside of a peach in here, there is a what's called a pit or a stone. It's seed, okay, but it's very, very hard, really hard, and you can't eat it, but it's basically the seed, and it's unlike an apple that has many seeds inside, an apple or a pear, a peach has a pit. It's very hard, one seed, and so this is a terrible picture. It doesn't even show the pit inside, which is the major identifying character of a peach. So, anyway, sorry about that. Peaches, do you know what peaches are, Alejandro? They're like yellow.
Yes.
Yellow,
I know.
To red.
Yes, he is sweet.
Okay. Yes. Very sweet? Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Very delicious. I miss peaches. In the United States, they grow peaches a lot in the South. Here in the Philippines, you don't see peaches. Rarely. They can't grow them here. I don't know. I don't see peaches in Asia very often. Okay, Mike, back to you. Find me the next word.
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay, next one. See it? A pineapple.
Yeah. Is number 10.
Yes, it is. Well, certainly that is a pineapple. Okay. Mike, do you ever eat pineapples?
Yeah. I like a lot of it's good. It's very well.
Yeah. Here where I live in the Philippines, they sell pineapples on the street. They have street vendors with little glass carts packed with ice and big pieces of pineapple. It's terrific. It's really cold, and it's great when you're out on the street in a hot day. And it's cheap, really cheap. Okay. Next one, Seth.
Okay.
Find me.
Grapes. Yes. Grapes. Is it number 15?
It definitely is number 15. Excellent. There are similar looking things on the page, but you can definitely tell from the leaves. Okay. Seth.
Yes.
What wonderful thing can we make with grapes?
Sorry?
What wonderful, wonderful, wonderful beverage do we make with grapes?
It's always I have grapes in my home.
Yes?
Yes.
Okay.
My children, eat grapes frequently. Yeah.
All right. And what happens when we ferment grapes? We add a little yeast, let them rot a little. Do ferment? No? Okay.
No.
Okay. Yeah, one of the biggest human inventions. Yeah, one of the greatest inventions of all time. Wine, of course. Of course we make wine from grapes. Sure. Okay, the next one. Very British. Armando.
Currants. The fish.
Yeah, very good. I think there's black currants, red currants. All right. Have you ever eaten currants or maybe currant jelly?
Only in the desert.
Okay. Only in the what?
In the desert with a cake, with currant cake.
Wow. In a recipe.
Yes.
Okay. All right. Yeah, I've only had like red currant jam, actually, not jelly. Or maybe jelly. I don't know. Well, like you're saying, only when it's been processed and cooked. I've never actually seen a currant in its raw form myself. Okay. Moving along. Lisa.
It is plums.
Plums, all right. Where are plums?
It is number. Number six.
I don't think so.
No.
Looks somewhat similar to a plum again.
Yes,
sorry
but
for the bad picture.
Yes. It is 14.
Yeah, 14. Yes, it is 14. It has more of an oblong, this shape. An apple has a round shape, like a circle. I believe number 14 are plums, because plums have a little bit of a longer shape often. Really? I think so. Yes. I had the chance to preview and use process of elimination, so I cheated a little bit. But when I looked at everything else, that's the only thing I could come up with for plums, really. Because they do have a sort of a long or oblong shape. Plums also, like peaches, have a pit or a stone. What color? Yeah, colors would be helpful. What color, Alisa, are plums? Do you know?
I can say the natural in the natural fruit, I don't know the colors, but this is written is black. I don't know what is the color in natural fruit.
Okay. Plums are basically almost black because they're dark, dark purple. Yeah, that's right. Sweet. They have very sweet flavored fruit. Plums are good. You don't see them that often. All right, moving on. Alejandro, where are the...
Yes, cherries and... Sartine.
Very good. Okay. All right, very good. Cherries, of course, red. They also have a pit. Or stone. A cherry has a small one seed, very hard seed inside. Do you ever eat cherries?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. That's another one that living in Asia, I don't ever see cherries anymore. Which is very strange because, of course, Japan is famous for cherry blossoms, China, cherry blossoms. But I never see cherries anymore here in the Philippines where I live. I see a lot of other really strange exotic fruit here. that we're not looking at today, but I don't see cherries. All right, next one, Mike. Oh, Mike, yeah, you're here. Oh. Mike, are you here?
I'm here.
Yeah, yeah. All right. All right, next one. All right, strawberries.
I don't see
eight. Yeah, sure.
Number eight.
Strawberries are number eight. Yes, they are. Why are strawberries unique in the plant world? Well, unique, well, as far as fruit. What makes strawberries completely unique compared to other fruit? Do you know? I was asking what makes strawberries special. They're not like any other fruit. They're unique. Unique means one of a kind, unlike any other. The type of fruit, they're unique.
I don't know.
Okay, well, I'll tell you. Does anybody know? What is different about strawberries than any other fruit? No?
No, I don't know.
Okay, nobody knows? Okay, well, strawberries have the seeds on the outside of the fruit. Have you ever looked at a strawberry? Yes, the seeds are outside in the skin of the outside of the fruit. Every other fruit, the seeds are on the inside. So they're a little bit different. Okay, Jorge, how about raspberries?
Let me see. Maybe it's 11.
Maybe it is. Okay, very good. 11, definitely.
Do you know that it is a device named Raspberry?
A what device?
Raspberry Pi.
What's that? A device?
It's like a microcomputer.
Oh. No, I did not.
I can share you an image.
Yeah, it's... Okay. Did you know that
raspberry. Raspberry Pi. Oh, I put the link in the chat.
Okay. Interesting. Do you know that raspberry has another meaning in English? It is an actual motion or activity or... kind of a sound as well. Did you know that, Jorge?
No, I don't know.
Okay, then stick your tongue out of your mouth, and then blow really hard. That's a raspberry, right?
Yeah.
So, yes, it is. So if you blow someone a raspberry, okay, that's what you're doing.
Did you see the link?
No, not yet. Oh, shoot.
No. Raspberry.
Okay, I have to switch gears to look at the link. I can take a look at it, I guess. Okay, in the meantime, let me quickly welcome Carlos to the class. Hello, Carlos.
Hello, teacher.
Welcome. And, okay, we're almost done here. Carlos, I'll come around to you in a bit. Seth, can you find me a pomegranate?
Pomegranate is the number two.
There we go. Very good. Okay, lots of seeds inside. Do you ever eat pomegranates, Seth?
Yes, in my country, grown pomegranate is some difficult eat.
Okay. Really? okay. Ground pomegranate?
Yes.
Really? Okay.
Yes, my country grown this fruit.
Oh, okay. All right, interesting. Someone had asked about raspberries, and yes, there are raspberries, and then there are blackberries, which look very similar. Raspberries and blackberries, but of course the color, obviously. Blackberries are a little smaller. Okay. Pomegranate's kind of a pain in the neck to eat, but the juice is great. All right. All right. Anyway, one more. Armando, find me a melon. Of course, obviously, there are many kinds of melon.
Melon, the six.
Number six. Yeah, you can see the seeds inside.
It look a pinky, but melon.
Yeah, it looks like a pumpkin or something.
Pumpkin, yes.
Yeah, because they have the stem on top. But yeah, a pumpkin, by the way, just because we mentioned it, a pumpkin is actually a kind of a gourd. Sometimes people get confused with gourds and melons. Gourds are types of squash, really. But melons are melons. Of course, there's many types of melons. What are some types of melons you can think of, Armando? Can you think of any types of melons?
In English, no.
Okay. Well, of course, there's watermelon, the big green one with the pink inside. There's honeydew, the green inside. Cantaloupe, the ones that are orange inside. There's tons and tons, really. Many different ones. Okay. So much for our fruits. Let's move on to vegetables. Okay, this could be challenging because of the pictures here. And sometimes different words even. There's a couple that have called something different, British English and American English. But anyway, let's give it a try. Alisa, starting with potato. Can you find me a potato? Potato. Alisa, are you there? Alisa? Hello? Okay, maybe a connection problem, maybe? Alisa? Oh. All right, I'm not sure. I'll skip you coming and come around back to you later. Alejandro, potato. Potato.
Yes, number eight.
Number eight, most certainly. Again, another variety of vegetable we eat with lots of variations, many, many types of potatoes. What can you make with potatoes?
Potato chips.
Yes.
Or fries, potato fries.
French fries. Yeah. Okay, very good. Do you know what potato chips are called in British English?
And British English, chips.
Yeah, okay, well, potato chips, American potato chips, are crisps in British English, and American French fries are called chips in British English. So a little confusing there with the potato products. Okay, and where do potatoes grow?
In the ground.
In the ground. Yes, they do. potato, potato, tomato, tomato. Doesn't really matter if your pronunciation is slightly different. Okay, let me quickly welcome Anna Christina to the class. Hello, Anna. Hi, Anna.
Hello, Audrey. How are you?
I'm doing okay. Welcome. Okay, Carlos. It's time to find the mushroom. Where is the mushroom in these pictures?
The mushroom in the number 9?
Nine. Of course. These are mushrooms. Where do mushrooms grow, Carlos?
Mushroom grow in a surface?
Sure, they grow in the ground, so on the soil, fine. And they grow pretty much everywhere. yes, they like it a little bit dark, but they pretty much grow everywhere. And do you know any types of mushrooms?
Yes. There's a town in my country that they grow up in the forest.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, in the United States, in North America, there are many, many types of mushrooms. Edible. You can eat it edible. Edible wild mushrooms, but of course you have to be very careful about what mushrooms you're eating. Yeah. Because you could poison yourself, or you could make yourself very, very high eating the wrong kind of mushrooms. You've got to be careful. The ordinary mushrooms that you usually see in stores or canned mushrooms, normally these are called button mushrooms. They're just sort of generic mushrooms. But, of course, there are many, many, many varieties of mushrooms that are edible. Shiitakes, chanterelles, oyster mushrooms, lots and lots. And they are delicious. Anyway, do you like to eat mushrooms, Carlos? Do you like mushrooms?
Yes, I've eaten mushrooms before. Mm-hmm. I love
them. You like them?
Yeah,
I like them. My wife hates them. I love mushrooms, though. So I don't get to cook with them often. Okay, next one. Anna, Christina. Easy one. All right, find a carrot.
I know what it is. It's delicious, but I don't know how to say in English. It's my favorite.
What? Okay.
Yeah.
Can you find a carrot here in the pictures?
The number 10.
Number 10? It's not a carrot. It's definitely not a carrot. No. Nope. Number 10 is definitely not a carrot. want to take a second guess? The clue. Potatoes and onions and carrots and turnips are called root vegetables. So it looks like a root. Anna, can you not find it?
And number 8 is a potato.
Yes, it is. Not number 8. It's not number... Not number 10, not number 8, 10. Well, here it is, number 12. If you can imagine that being orange color. All right, it's a carrot. You know, pretty much carrots are carrots. Unlike potatoes, of which there are many, many varieties, and mushrooms, which there are literally hundreds of varieties, a carrot's a carrot's a carrot. And I think you can find carrots all over the world. I've never heard of any place that didn't have carrots. Or the next one either. Mike, where's the onion?
Let's see. Is number two.
Number two, of course. Of course you eat onions, Mike. Who doesn't eat onions? Do you like onions, Mike?
With pizza, steak, or...
Oh, sure. Of course.
Sometimes.
Onions are very, very common in many, many recipes. We use onions to cook with a lot. Okay, there are a few different varieties of onions. Vidalia onions, white onions, Bermuda onions, or red onions. Yeah. When I was a kid, Mike, I used to sneak out to the garden. I grew up in the countryside. I would sneak out to the garden when no one was looking. I would dig up onions and eat them like an apple. I love onions. I still love onions. Yeah, no kidding. It was my little after-school snack I would make myself. I'd go dig myself an onion. Jorge, but cabbage. Can you find me a cabbage?
Maybe number three.
Definitely number three. Okay, cabbages are green, light green in color. Do you eat cabbage, Jorge?
Yeah, in salads.
In salads, okay. There's a dish which is very common in Western cultures called coleslaw. Do you know what that is?
No.
Okay. You get it if any of you people have ever been to Kentucky Fried Chicken. if you get that little cup with very thinly sliced green cabbage and carrots, with a little mayonnaise in it and a little spices, that's coleslaw. Basically, a side dish which is very common.
Yes, it's true.
In Western. Sure, that's coleslaw. Okay, one of my favorite vegetables and very healthy. Next one here, Seth.
Yes, broccoli is number seven.
Yes, it is. Seth, when you were a child, did you play with the broccoli on your plate? Pretend it was little trees?
Yes, it's funny. Eat broccoli. It's great, yes.
Yeah.
I like it.
Can imagine you're a dinosaur? Roar!
Yes. The voice always funny with the broccoli in the plate.
Yeah. Right? Kids like to play with it because it looks like little trees. Little tiny
yes,
trees.
Little trees.
Yeah, sure. All right. Great. Glad to know I'm not the only one. All right. Armando, how about the next one here.
Turnip.
Turnip. Yep. All right. Can you find me a turnip?
Thirteen.
Yes, sir. You are correct. All right. Do you know what color a turnip is?
White.
Well, okay. Yeah, you're right. I forgot. But sometimes they're purple. Sometimes they're white on top and then purple more like on the bottom.
Correct.
Yeah. Here's another vegetable I don't see anymore, which is too bad because I really like turnips. Do you like turnips, Armando?
Not much.
Not much? Many kids don't like them. Many people don't like them, I should say. I always loved turnips. Most kids hate turnips, but I always loved them. The flesh, when we talk about, now of course, you think of flesh, maybe you think of meat or fish, but in fact, we can also talk about the flesh of vegetables and fruit, and the flesh of the turnip, the inside, when you peel away the skin, is kind of yellow, yellowish anyway, if you when you cook it. And it has a very distinct flavor, almost a little bit bitter. I don't know. I really like it, but in any case, moving on. Alisa, are you?
It's leek.
It's leek, all right.
It's number... Eleven.
Yes, it is. Very good. Alik is kind of a member of the onion family.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, but you can eat the bottom, the bulb. Oh, by the way. All right. Well, okay. The bottom part here near the roots would be called the bulb. You can eat the bulb, and you can also eat part of the stem. And you can also eat a little bit of the leaves. So you can eat the whole thing. Do you ever eat leeks, Elisa?
Yes, but I don't like the I don't like this.
You don't like the?
No, okay. I don't like it too much.
I do. I like potato leeks. I just love food. I love all food, whatever. Okay, the next one may cause you problems, Alejandro, or maybe not. Do you know what this is? You might not.
Sorry.
I didn't. I had to look it up. I didn't know what it was.
I have an idea. I think it's like a cucumber. Okay. Or something like that.
Okay, you're way ahead of me. Okay, courgette. It has the television pronunciation courgette. I had to look it up before class because I'm an American, and Americans call these. I've never heard this word before, honestly. Americans call these zucchinis. A zucchini. So, where is it here, Alejandro?
Number six.
Yeah, a zucchini. Okay, grows on a. Do you know what this is called, Alejandro?
No.
Okay. Well, like grapes, zucchinis, mini squash, pumpkins, melons grow on vines. They grow on vines, long, stringy, like a piece of rope. Zucchinis are green. They grow on vines. They're actually a type of squash. In the United States, actually, I've lived in many places in the United States, and I found this to be true in many different places. Zucchinis grow like crazy. You can't stop them growing. They're like a weed. They're like grass or dandelions, I don't know. They grow like crazy. So if you grow zucchinis, you want to grow 12, but you grow 1,200. And it's very common in the United States to drive down country roads and see tables with free zucchini signs. People will try to give away as many zucchinis as possible because they're way too prolific. They grow... They're abundant. They're prolific. Prolific means they have many. They bear many, many, many fruit. They're out of control. And I kind of miss that. Anyway, free zucchini. Yeah, right. One of my favorite things to eat was a zucchini bread. It's very delicious. Okay, the next one also has a couple different names. Carlos? How about this next one?
Hello?
Sorry? Hello?
Hello?
Okay, how about this next one? Aubergine? Do you know what that is also the other name for that?
I don't know,
teacher. Okay. All right, the other name for that is Okay, again, British say aubergine or French, but Americans call this an eggplant. Eggplant. Do you know that name? Can you find me an eggplant, Carlos?
Okay, number 14.
There you go. What color is the eggplant?
Violet.
Yeah, violet. Or, well, violet's kind of a lighter purple. I guess they could be violet, but purple to dark purple often. And there's a couple varieties, kind of fatter ones and more thin ones. But, yeah, you ever eat eggplant, Carlos?
Yes, I've eaten eggplant, but I don't like it.
You don't like it? Okay.
Yeah.
As usual, I like it. Of course I do. I like all food. Eggplant parmesan is a favorite dish that I like to eat. Okay, moving on. Anna, Christina, how about this next one? Anna, are you there? Yeah.
Hello.
Hello, okay. The you know this next one? Yes, please.
Cauliflower? Cauliflower. Very good.
Cauliflower, very good. And which number represents cauliflower?
Number one.
Number one, definitely. Okay, and the color of cauliflower?
It's the lace is the cauliflower.
I'm sorry?
I like the cauliflower.
You like cauliflower?
My favorite vegetable. Yeah.
Okay. And what color is cauliflower?
The cauliflower is, I don't know in English.
Well, it's white, usually.
No, it's white. It's...
Huh.
No, it's... For me, no, it's white. It's like to color white, but it's beige.
Oh, okay. All right. White, yellow, cream color. Yeah, okay, good. Or hey, maybe cream color, off-white. Sometimes we say off-white. Okay. There are varieties. They've learned how to make different varieties that are, I've seen purple cauliflower, pink cauliflower. Yellow cauliflower. Yeah, experimenting with food, I guess. I don't know, but.
Do you have cauliflower in the United States, teacher?
In the United States, it's quite common. Absolutely. Really? They have it. I live in the Philippines. They have cauliflower here in the Philippines as well. But cauliflower and broccoli are a little bit expensive. They're hard to grow here in the Philippines. You can find it anywhere, but it's expensive. Broccoli and cauliflower cost more than steak, like beef steak here in the Philippines. So it's a special treat. It's easy to find, but it's expensive. This next one, on the other hand, is, okay, it's common in America, but it's completely very hard or impossible to find in the Philippines or in Asia. This next one, Mike...
Yes, I'm here.
Yeah.
Let me see. Is number four?
Brussels sprouts. Yes.
Yeah.
Brussels sprouts. Very.
Brussels sprouts. Yes.
Yeah. Here's another one. That's it. But usually, yes, it's Brussels sprouts. Technically, that's true. But yeah, you know, Americans delete the S actually, or we don't. At least we don't pronounce it, and often they don't even spell it on the package. But
usually,
of course,
usually
anyway.
Only sprouts.
Sorry.
Usually only sprouts in the USA.
Now, usually Brussels sprouts. We just not Brussels and sprouts. Brussels sprouts, definitely. Most American kids hate Brussels sprouts. Of course, I love them, but I'm a freak. Okay, Brussels sprouts, they're little round things. They look like tiny, tiny little cabbages, actually, and they taste a little bit similar to cabbages, actually. A little bit. They're a little bit bitter, so children don't like them. Mike, do you like Brussels sprouts?
Nah, I don't like.
Yeah.
I don't like Brussels.
Okay. Many people don't. Okay, Jorge. All we are seeing, Jorge, yeah. Give yeah. Bees a chance.
Bees.
Bees, man. Bees, man.
He sells, but who is buying? Bees, man, number, number five?
No. No, those are not bees. This is one that many non-English speakers get confused.
Number 15.
Right. These are peas. Now, many non-English speakers refer to these as beans or a type of bean or something, but English speakers always call these peas. There's different varieties of peas. There's peas that you can eat the whole, just the peas inside, and then there's peas that you can eat the whole thing. Or hey, do you know what the whole thing is called? This inside of the peas, but what are the peas inside of?
I don't know. How can I name this that shell?
The shell is called a pod. Okay. Yes, that's called a pod. A pea pod. If I use the idiom like two peas in a pod to talk about people, I mean that they're exactly alike. They act alike. They look alike. The twins are like two peas in a pod. So I could mean that they look alike, like twins, or I could mean that they act alike, or I could mean that they are always together, doing the same things together all the time. They're like two peas in a pod. Very similar is the idea. Okay, so those are peas. On the other hand, beans. Seth?
Where's the beans? Yes, beans. I think it's in number five.
Yeah, and of course there's many different varieties of beans. Beans, yellow beans, wax beans, string beans, yes. Many, many kinds of beans. Right. And I'm sure you have beans. Of course, there's the beans that you need to boil forever, all right, like rice and beans. Then there's the beans that you cook this whole pod and eat. Really, a couple kinds of beans. All right, next one here, Armando. Sweet corn.
Sweet corn.
Number 10, of course. Do you like corn, Armando?
I like it. Yes.
All right. Do you know how to describe this picture? How do you describe this corn?
Here in Spain, the people usually eat the corn fresh.
Okay. In English, this corn right here would be corn on the cob. That piece of the plant each piece of corn is called a kernel of corn, and the kernels are attached to a cob. So if you have corn on the cob,
yeah,
all right.
In the cinema, popcorn.
What's that? I'm sorry?
At the cinema, popcorn.
Popcorn. Oh, yeah, I forgot. Right. Then there's popcorn, of course. Okay, definitely related. All right. Here in the Philippines, they really like corn. They sell corn on the street. You can buy roasted corn. There's vendors that sell roasted corn, boiled corn, hot buttered corn. They have corn ice cream, believe it or not. People like to eat here. It's kind of funny.
Cakes of corn.
What's that? Corn cakes. Ah, yeah, yeah, okay. Yes, well, that was common in the United States, actually. yeah. Cornbread. We call that cornbread, actually. Very good. Yes, corn ice cream is very popular here in the Philippines. Kind of funny. what can I tell you? I don't know. I don't like it myself, but some people do. It seems to be quite popular. All right, here's some we missed. We've got a few minutes. Some we didn't talk about. Elisa.
Lettuce.
Lettuce. All right. Which one is that?
It is number 5.
Yes, it is. And, of course, there are many, many, many different types and varieties of lettuce. Do you know a couple different kinds of lettuce?
The name, you say.
Yeah. Do you know any types of lettuce?
In English, I don't know.
No? Okay.
No.
There's the really round, tight one is iceberg. There's red leaf lettuce, which obviously has red leaves. Green leaf lettuce. Oh, there's so many types of lettuce. It's ridiculous. But, okay. Elisa, do you like salads? Do you like to make a salad with lettuce?
Yes, I love the salad.
Mm-hmm, okay. Yeah, me too. Okay, Alejandro. But the next one here. Oh, Alejandro's gone. I'm sorry. Carlos, next one here. Tomatoes.
Macho with pitcher. Number 6.
Number 6, yes. Number 6, tomatoes. Again, many varieties of tomatoes. Very common all over the world. Actually, most of these are very common. Anna, almost out of time here, so where's the cucumber?
Cucumber. Oh, number 1.
Sure. What does it mean, Anna, if I say Anna is cool as a cucumber?
Cucumber.
Anna is as cool as a cucumber. Mm. This is a fairly common idiom or expression. No idea? Well, it just means that you remain calm. No? The idea, we say it about people, not about things. So it means that that person remains calm under pressure. They don't get nervous. They don't get scared. They just remain calm, even under pressure. As cool as a cucumber. Okay, Mike, celery. Mike? Okay. All right, we've only got a minute left, so Jorge, where's the celery here?
Number 4.
Yes. How many calories in one stalk of celery? By the way, each long piece is called a...
I have no idea.
Like one. There's almost no calories. Celery and pickles, cucumber pickles, celeries and cucumbers have almost no calories. They're almost virtually empty of calories. As opposed to an avocado, which has a lot of calories. In fact, the most calories in any fruit or vegetable can be found in the lovely avocado. Seth, where's the avocado here?
It's number 3, teacher.
Yes, it is. Do you like avocados?
Yes. in sandwich and salads.
Me too. I also do that. I like to put avocados in sandwiches and all kinds of things. And I love to make my own special guacamole, Seth.
Yes, and awesome. Guacamole.
Yeah, it's good. All right, finally we've got peppers, or sometimes Americans at least would call these bell peppers, because of course there are many, many types of peppers, hot peppers, etc. But this one in the picture, I would call these bell peppers. They can be red, yellow, green. Okay, we are out of time, so I want to thank everyone for joining the class and talking about fruits and vegetables. Thanks a lot, guys. See you next time here on Verbaling.
See you.